from creativeguitarstudio.com. So if you're tired of what you're playing when it comes to anything related to solos or melody and you want to do something about it, then you have come to the right place. Because as always in my 7-day lessons, I'll give you a no-fail game plan for making that happen, no matter what your solos or melodies are like right now. So let's talk about that for a second. What does your lead playing sound like right now? A lot of times guitar players get hooked on using too many of the same ideas from textbook scale patterns rather than from unique and different scale patterns. So that's what we're going to fix, and we'll do it all in 7 days or less. Also, in the second half of this lesson over on my Patreon page, you're going to get to watch a bonus video where I'm going to show you how to take what we'll do here and add to it with a larger, more involved scale. After we're all done, you'll have better melodic control over any song or any piece of music that you perform. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations. To donate and download your copy today. The idea that we're going to focus on is one that was first shown to me by one of my old guitar instructors over at the Musicians Institute. His name was Norman Brown. Definitely going to want to check out his music. He's an absolutely great guitar player, and he's a fantastic teacher as well. Now, the unique scale layout that he showed me many, many years ago takes place around the notes that are set up into unisons. Now, what I'm going to do here for you is set up a minor pentatonic that's going to go between a couple of unison tones separated on the neck and, you know, maybe by a couple of whole steps apart, maybe two or three whole steps. And how this works is you are going to have a scale that's very unique because we're not thinking from the typical root to octave setup. We're not going in a much more vertical sense. We're traveling very horizontal with it. And it helps you get to thinking about lines in a different way as well. So first of all, what I want to do is show you a setup of some notes here where you can start learning how this is organized. You may want to do it kind of more in a position-based idea in the very beginning. Kind of see it set up on the neck as two areas. But what I want to do is take this layout and have you think about it in terms of a connected sense. So something like that, you know, where you're moving much more laterally all the time. To help you get into this, I'm going to just demonstrate a breakdown of something I put together for you to learn. It goes like this. You notice how we're feeding from this A note to this one, which is its unison tone, same note, but just in a different location. And I mean, it's exact same note. It's not like an octave where we have a, you know, same note up eight tones higher. You can tell range different, the range difference is there, but we don't have that with unisons. It is literally the exact same note. So, you know, think about that in terms of how your neck is laid out and how you can start utilizing that, because it forces you to play horizontal. Now, that was one pattern that was down in the lower register end of the neck. Let's get a new one together here for you that's off of the fourth guitar string A, and that's going to have a unison over here on the 12th fret, 5th string. So 7th fret, 4th string A to its unison up here on the 5th string, 12th fret. So just a general layout of things first. Could set it up like that, you know, as one region. And that one as another region. But what you want to be doing, you know, as you're practicing this, is getting them to flow between each other. Seamless, like how you move is really, really comfortable. Now, let me go through an example, you know, connection phrase that I have here for you so you can learn something that'll help you get started. Okay, one more time. So we're working again from this A to its unison over over here. So 4th string, 7th fret to the 5th string, 12th fret. So these are the basic patterns that I have set up here for you in these unison minor pentatonics. Start by just becoming familiar with either both of them if you have the time to fit it in your schedule, but if not, just at least in the first couple of days, get into knowing one of these really well. After you've committed to memory these two A minor pentatonic patterns that are using the unison scale layout, the next and most important step is to apply them into a melodic situation. We're going to set the stage for this by using these shapes behind a backing track rhythm guitar part that's based in A minor. Then I'll give you a melodic idea that uses the unison scale patterns, and finally we'll wrap things up by going over how to take these unison scales and use them in improvisation. What we're going to be doing is taking a look at an A minor key backing track, so we want that tonality in the back there. And then over top of that, we're going to be using our unison pentatonic to create an example melody for you. Now, this backing track I have for you, it is available if you're a Patreon member, so you're going to get the download of the MP3 jam, and you can utilize it to go over the melody as well as, you know, we're going to be talking a little bit later about improvisation as well. And if you are a Patreon member on top of that, remember, we've got our bonus second video that's going to be there covering how to take this stuff up to the next level with the full natural minor scale as well, so you don't want to miss that. Let's get into this chord progression here that we're going to be using for our backing track. It sounds like this. So those chord changes are A minor, and then G with an A in the bass. F with A in the bass, and then C with A, and G with A. So there are small shapes that are being built between 4th and 2nd strings with a droning A open 5th string underneath in all of them. So it makes it kind of modal, where we have this strong loop of a droning A in the bass. It really locks it down into the sound of the A minor key. And all the chord changes are really strong too to take us back and anchor that sound of A minor. So it's a nice chord progression. And like I said, if you're a Patreon member, you're going to get that as a backing track download. So now let's move from there into talking about how you can use the unison pentatonic scale to create a melody. So first thing I want to do is just play this melody example that I have for you. So let's just jam that out first. Okay, let's go through it. It's really simple. We're using both of the registers because remember we did a unison pentatonic scale pattern that was down in the lower area, and then we also did one in the upper area. So let's start off. We have our first note is an A note on that 2nd fret 3rd string. Then we have a G coming back to that A. So we're all just set up right there in the 2nd position. That's for our first measure. And then for the 2nd measure, we're jumping into the 5th position, and we're coming at it by way of 3rd string 7 and 5. So that's a D and a C going upward to a higher E note on 2nd string 5th fret, and then dropping down to the D again. Now that D is a nice tone because it links up well with our G major sound, because it's the perfect 5th tone for that G major chord. A strong sound. So now from there we're heading, remember, into the color of the F major chord now. So we're going to have a line that's a little bit busier, steady 8th notes here. All right, so there's a pattern that's going on 3rd string 7, 9, 4th string 10 into 7. So that is a D, E, C, A, and then we do a slide from 7 to 9. That's the D to the E. And then what we're going to do next is have our 12th fret note on 4th string, that's a D, dropping down to a C. And you notice what's happening as we're traveling along the neck with this unison pentatonic. Not only are we having a lot of unisons with those A tones, you know, that's really obvious and we've been focusing on that, but we're having unisons now show up along the line that are of other tones. We just saw that happen with a C and a D, and you know, it's really interesting how this gets broken down on the neck, because when you start organizing how to move along the guitar, one of the things that you do find, even though you are changing registers, is you're getting getting a lot of the same notes that just start repeating. You know, you had a note on, let's say, third string, and that exact same note can be located about 5 frets up over on the fourth string, and then about 5 frets up again on the fifth string. So keep that in mind, because you're going to get a lot of really cool sounds that take advantage of the different colors of the strings, because, you know, as a string gets shorter scale length and gets thicker in diameter, gives you a different sound tonally. So let's go into what's happening on the last measure here. We have a faster scale run from 7-10, 7-10, fifth string into fourth string. So it's kind of a little quick because we got 16th notes on those ones. It's a E, G, D, or A and C, pardon me. So E, G, A, C. And then we have a slide D, E. So that's going to be eighth notes now. And then we're ending here on a D note, and that's a G chord in the background again. So remember, we were talking about that a little earlier, how a D note is a strong tone for your G chord because it's the perfect fifth there. All right, so there's some really nice stuff happening along this line. It's pretty basic. I mean, we're not doing any kind of shredding or anything. It's easy to learn. Spend some time on that, and it's going to be really helpful if you're a Patreon member and you've got that downloadable MP3 jam track for that chord progression I was playing there in the key of A minor. So anyway, this is some nice stuff to get you started, get these shapes down, learn some of the melody ideas, and then what my final suggestion would be with this stuff is to move on and do some improvisation. So if you are a Patreon member and you do get that MP3 jam track download, then that's great. You can fire that up and work with it and, you know, use it as a backdrop. But if you don't, I mean, you can just record these chord changes and, you know, get them yourself at home, you know, down pat. And then once that's happening, start trying to play over them using these unison pentatonic patterns that we've gone over and just try to make stuff up. So I'm going to take you out by just playing along with that jam loop and making a few things up using these scale patterns. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video where we're going to move beyond the pentatonic unison patterns and we'll add the remaining notes to the key so that you'll achieve the full key signature with all 7 scale tones operating between those unison note layouts. And in doing this, you're going to learn to use this method and apply it so that within around 1 week's time, you'll be performing melodies and solos with these new unison scale layouts. And let me tell you, man, these things are so cool. Plus, you got to remember, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get the jam tracks. You'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout. And that thing is great because it shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.